Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, and in this video I will show you how you can generate a stable 50Hz and 1kHz signal without a microcontroller but just using this 4.096MHz crystal and a few logic ICs. With this, let's get started with the project. These are all the components required to generate the required square waves. It includes the binary counter IC 4060 and the logic IC 7490. The heart of this project is this 4.096MHz crystal, which is used to provide stable clock signals to the 4060 binary counter IC. Now let us have a look at the two ICs which I've used to generate these frequencies. The first one is the CD4060, which is a binary counter or divider, which has also a feature of external oscillations inputs. The great feature of this IC is that it contains a Schmitt trigger, which is ideal if you want to hook up a crystal to the external oscillation circuit, which is exactly what I have done. In this image, you can see the dividing factors of the 4060. Over here on pin 1, you can see that it has a divide factor of 4096. Hooking up a crystal of 4.096MHz gives us exactly a frequency of 1kHz at pin 1. On pin 2, we have a divide factor of 8192, which is exactly double of that in the pin 1. We can get a stable 500Hz from pin 2. The next IC that I've used is the 7490, which is a decade and a binary counter. This IC basically combines a divide by 5 circuit and a divide by 2 circuit, giving us a divide by 10 circuit all in all. Now previously we saw that we can generate a stable 500Hz from 4060. Dividing 500 by 10 gives us the 50Hz, which is exactly what I've done. I firstly divided the 500Hz by 5 and then used the divide by 2 feature to divide it by 2 again, giving us our desired 50Hz. Now this is the schematic of the entire project, and as you can see that I have hooked up the 4.096MHz crystal to pins 10 and 11 with the necessary 22 pF capacitor. As seen in the datasheet earlier, we get a stable 1kHz frequency on pin 1 and stable 500Hz frequency on pin 2. This 500Hz frequency is then fed to the IC 7490, which first divide the frequency by 5, which gets the output to 100Hz, and then finally it divides it by 2 to get our stable 50Hz at the output. We can get the 50Hz at pin 12 and 1kHz at pin 1 of 4060. With the schematic diagram and circuit explanation on the way, let's make this circuit on the breadboard. Since the project does not have too many components, it is fairly easy to set up the circuit on a breadboard and get it working. It is also a good idea to keep your breadboard connections neat and tight so as to avoid any confusions or wrong connections of the circuit. With all the breadboard connections done, this is how the circuit looks like. It is now time to test it and evaluate the final output. For this, I am using this small DSO138 scope, which is enough to get an idea about the output signals. With the scope powered on, it is now time to power on our logic circuit, for which I am using the 7805 voltage regulator, since both of my ICs are 5V tolerant and any voltage above 5V will kill these ICs. To power the 7805, I am using this 9V battery. And as you can see, as soon as we plug the oscilloscope probe on pin 1 of the 4060, we are greeted with this stable 1kHz signal, just as we expected. Next, it is time to visualize the 50Hz signal. And as you can see that we have the 50Hz signal representation on pin 12 of the 7490 IC. Adjusting the time base of the oscilloscope also gives us an idea that both the 1kHz and the 50Hz signal have a perfect 50% duty cycle. Since the timing component of this project is a crystal, it is not affected by ambient temperatures in case of an RC timing circuit. This makes the project highly stable and reliable. With this, we can get the stable signals which can be used to test various kind of circuits. I hope this small project was informative for you. If so, feel free to share your feedbacks and suggestions in the comment section below. If you like this video, consider subscribing to my channel for more such project and informative content.